Hi, my friend, this is Elizabeth, and welcome to Sube la Vibra. Today, our special guest is Dr. Sue Morter. Dr. Sue, welcome to Sube la Vibra, and thank you very much for being here with us in Sube la Vibra.
Oh, absolutely. It's my pleasure to be here. I look forward to seeing what we get to talk about today.
Dr. Sue, can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Certainly. I grew up in an environment of natural healthcare. Quantum science was our regular dinner table conversation. I've never gone to the doctor and taken an antibiotic for some ailment. I know that the body has the ability to heal itself. And so I have been living those principles all my life. Mm-hmm. In my early, about 20 years ago, I had an experience with meditation that allowed me to awaken to a much higher state of consciousness, which I didn't have any idea existed prior to the experiences that I was having. I had no reference points to really understand what was happening with me. And I turned the next 10 years of my life into a laboratory, a living laboratory, to really figure out what had happened and how could I return to those states and what was I supposed to benefit from them? And a byproduct of that is I healed a scoliosis in my body. I healed migraine headaches as a pattern that I was experiencing. And a larger, bigger picture byproduct of all of it has been that a deep sense of anxiousness and horrific intimidation in life. As I grew up as a kid, very, very intimidated and prohibitively shy, I'm now living an entirely different kind of life, having every week of my life being filled with audiences, speaking to 90,000 people live or hundreds of thousands of people live on the internet, but having an opportunity to share our ability to self-heal and our ability to awaken to a greater purpose and a greater sense of who we are has been so transformational in my life that I have devoted my life to teaching other people how to do the same, really to open to embracing fears and transforming them into passionate purpose and power in our lives is really what I'm very interested in doing. So I look forward to seeing how that's applicable in our conversation today. And I'm happy to delve in more specifically in any of those arenas. But that's me in a nutshell.
That's awesome. Wow, that is very interesting. In your book, The Energy Code, in the first chapter, you say that we are energy. For some of our audience, they are aware of that. They are very familiar with this concept. But for those that are not familiar, can you explain that, please?
Certainly. Now, science is showing us that everything is energy. It's just energy. And that's something we never really thought about in our lives. We thought there's this thing called energy, and then there's us. And so what science is showing us is that even all physical matter is just energy compressed. When you take energy and you start compacting it, it eventually generates physical form. So anything that we pick up, an item that we see, is actually just compressed energy. So if you unpack it, pulling the molecules apart and pulling the atoms apart, that there's empty space in between, and that empty space is this energy that we're referencing. If you were to decompress the physical human system, it would just become this unified field of energy. So it's kind of a mind bender for us to think in those terms. But and the benefit of thinking in those terms is this, that if everything is energy and energy is just vibrating at different frequencies, we can change our life experience by changing the vibrational frequencies that we dial our minds into. And it changes the movie that we're walking around inside of. It changes our come from, it changes our perspective on life, it changes everything. It allows us to heal, it allows us to flow in an energetic stream the way we're supposed to be flowing. And I think that's something that really is relevant to the conversations that we're likely to get into today. is that this energy that we are is supposed to be flowing and moving inside our bodies. And if it's moving inside of our bodies, it also moves in our lives. And when it moves in our bodies and in our lives, things heal and they change and they evolve and they grow. And if it gets blocked or stuck, then we don't heal and we start to implode and we start to toxify and become ill, or we become weak, or we become stagnant in different ways of thinking. We become locked into our belief patterns and kind of shut ourselves into boxes. And so what I'm really interested in people learning how to do is how to move the energy in their bodies so that they can start to move the energy in their lives. And a byproduct of that is that we heal on every level, emotionally, mentally, physically, spiritually. We reconnect with the truth of who we are, and everything begins to change under those circumstances.
That's awesome.